नो इज वॉट यू आर।
दुगड़ो
what you are describing is not in sunrise effect on you and its effect on your body you are not describing. You know, this is the one that is important. And what you capture is essential element you are in or poetry.
Not the effect on the body.
Not the effect on the body. It is one literary movement.
But
this
is a very implicit
describing
only what affects us.
What not what affects you, what affects you.
Yes.
So it is the essential part that you are trying to share with somebody.
Okay.
Not don't if you say okay, it's very simple.
No.
So your spiritual religious experiences are no different from any other sensual. Are you ready to accept it? Then it loses all its well.
No, but there's a hierarchy there.
You can introduce
there is a hierarchy there.
That is see, that is perpetuated. Why do you not? No hierarchy there. How can there be any hierarchy?
For us, there's a hierarchy.
You see, that there we went there, and what was the question? Most important question. I am worried all the time whether I will have enough fish to survive. I go out to 10 kilometers. That is affecting my body. It's salt, you see. And you have enough food to eat, you see, but I don't have. I'm a starving man. There was no trace of jealousy, there was no trace of envy in him, because he's a well-fed fellow. It's very interesting, Swamiji could have informed this conversation. Very interesting. And so, I said, he is also worried.
Which did not make sense to him.
Huh?
Which did not make sense.
Which did not make, I see, even further explanation that the content is exactly the same, whether this man's worry or your man's worry. So the content of sorrow I didn't want to use because I said
so what are you saying that you being worried about not getting enlightenment, me getting worried about my not being number one in my field as a skilled man.
That man
and that man
2,000 rupees every day.
His content is same.
The worry that you see it catches fire, the whole village will be wiped out. What we want is only a small brick wall.
Exactly.
With some room for worry that we are safe, that we come home and sleep well. That's all that we are interested in.
Basically.
That's just, no, it won't stop there. Then you see, so when I pointed out this, they were not upset. There was no trace of jealousy that all these people around us are wallowing in wealth, such mansions. And you see, what we are promised here, we are waiting for. Karunanidhi, we have elected this man. And what we had, the government took away, what the Christian missionaries gave us, that was taken away and is not replaced by anything.
So when you say that there is no need for literacy.
We saw affection there, but you see when the people came there, the teachers, there was something genuine about them, he said. They loved these children, they picked up these children, they played with these children. So whatever the motivation may be, we did not introduce the element of motive there. So we were happy and the government takes us everything, promising to give us something. And also the language problem we discussed with them. Very intelligent. So these are the things which you must put. So my comments and the whole talk of literacy.
But really, you are commenting. But what Sri Patola perhaps is going to do, he can sum up, he can give you what he wants, what he doesn't like. But that, don't you see the importance of that school there? You don't see anything?
20% of people in the United States are functionally illiterate, number one.
Right.
Number two, when there are elections, they are all educated people. When there are elections, 49% of the people stay away from elections. They don't exercise their brain. And so these jokers are elected with only 51% of the votes. And all the others are given the negative votes. So you have no business to cry about it. So the attitude of these people, we don't want that the mortician, what was his name, the fellow who from with Bush. They call him a mortician. He looks like
Dukakis.
Last time, one day, we don't want, they're very positive about that.
Yes.
We don't want that fellow. That's all.
we don't like this fellow. So we stray away.
So they are all literate, they are all educated people. Why they are not doing something that will stabilize the whole thing? See, all these are negative words given to the fellow who is elected. 29%, 20% of the people, these are not my, I am not making up these figures. You can go and refer to the statements of the Time magazine. That's my only source. You can blame them and not me. 20% of the people are illiterate in the United States. Why is there poverty in the country? Why are there slums there? Why 7,000 people every night have to sleep outside? They don't have shelters over their head. Why?
Because probably the people are not willing to do.
They are not willing. Are you willing to do it? Are these people willing to do something for them? They are not.
No,
I don't expect these people to do anything.
The people who are problem
in the United States,
they think it's their own doing.
It's also their own doing.
Yeah, no.
Same thing. Why don't they blow up the whole thing? You see, then you made a statement there. No, this is the situation. I don't think so. You have no right, you see, to have denying what belongs to them also. So I am not for a moment saying that you should give up. Nor am I saying that, you see, the United States should give up. You see, when I was lecturing in those days, one politician, I used to head up the Rotary Club. I made a statement about, you see, the aid they are giving, economic aid they are giving. It is not reaching the deserving people. What do you expect us? You see, if we hand it over to the government, they are swallowing it, we know. We know that.
No,
but you don't expect us to go there into the streets,
see,
there, stand there and distribute this goodies there. They will not allow us to do that. And the third thing is, do you think we are interested in giving money to them? We want to keep India out of the communist orbit. That's all that we are interested in.
Question is, you're saying that there's no need to for literacy.
Sir, you are a literate.
No, the question of
no, me. You answer this question. You are educated. You are reading the newspaper. What does it mean? Why do you want them to be literate? He's more literate than both of us put together. He's more intelligent than both of us put together.
No, what I'm saying is
all of us put together.
It comes to one point. It only comes to one point that you what society must do, what the government must do. It provides every child with a tool to make a living.
Not that. It is to brainwash those people to listen to all this crap.
But they don't seem to have a tool to make a living at the moment.
You give them tool to make a living.
They don't seem to have it at the moment.
Literacy is not the answer for that. Literacy is not the answer for
that.
No, that fellow also said, I stopped with my fifth grade or what you call this, standard or whatever it is. If I had the means, if I had the chance, I would have passed SSLC. No, I didn't have the chance. Then I didn't have the means to. There are no schools here, preschools here. Then?
No, but that's what I'm trying to say is the only thing you can really do to help them is to give them a tool to make a living.
How is it going to change? He will become the boss tomorrow. I'm not against that. He will organize the whole thing. He will become the leader there. He becomes very clever, cunning, crafty. I am not against that. See, please don't get me wrong. The honesty there, I'm not praising honesty. That boy said, I will get my 1 rupee. They will share with all the boys. He gave 20 rupees.
And they
shared
it.
In that context, you see, the whole conversation started. Don't worry, everybody will get his share here.
They were so decent.
I was surprised. So you know that I've been wanting to visit a village in India to see how it is like after so many years. You see, if you go there as somebody with the idea of collecting some statistics to see where it is. It was very unexpected. We just ambled along into that village. And those children came, you see, hugging me of all the persons. All the little urchins there, they started gathering around me. He was there, he was a rich man. He looked like a drug peddler or something.
But you said that he is 71.
Yeah, yes. And he wanted to say that he is a 71-year-old man, and he did not add how young he looks. He did not use.
But he understood.
So what? He didn't say, I am 63, I am going to be like him in another 7 years. His mathematics was correct. So what do you do?
His analysis
of the situation in this country is more intelligent, more realistic than all these literates are writing in the newspaper. And you want them to read. What for?
I agree.
What for? You tell me, I am not against literacy.
Doctor.
Sir, the way he has analyzed the situation, why they have chosen
Karunanidhi.
Yes. And we are waiting what he will do. Yes. We are waiting. What little we had, these governments have taken away. And the language problem also, we discussed in every. We want these programs that we play in our language. We want it in Tamil, you see, so that we are thousand people who have a small, tiny, little black and white television set there. We all sit there. We watch this Mahabharata and Ramayana. We know the stories and themes and the situations, but we don't understand. So we have to settle for the movements of their hands and movements of their lips.
Yeah.
What a tragedy it is, he said. We want that to be
examined. It's a crime, he says.
It's a crime.
It's a crime.
It's a crime to impose it, you see, on us.
Ah.
Yes, it is not a question of our inability.
It's a crime.
No, he went one step further and said, it is not a question of my inability or unwillingness to understand that language.
I can
learn a language. I will spend, if I can spend 10 days with him, I will learn his language and speak. I may not be able to read and write. Yes. That's not important.
He said that.
Yes, the literacy you are talking about.
That's what he said.
Yes, that's what he said. I may not be able to learn how to read and write, but I will be able to speak his language in 10 days. So this is a crime against us. You see, we want to watch it in our language. I am not against Hindi, he said. I am not against that. We go there and sit there from 8:40 the way I put it.
Finally, what is the parting line, he said? What is the point of coming? Give us something.
Huh?
What was he saying? If you don't come from Bombay, you must give us something. He said, it's the same story. When we are leaving finally.
Yes.
He said something, you must give us something. Do something for us.
I don't know.
Something he said.
Parting line. You all come from... from all those
places.
Places. I don't remember. Anyway, that's over. To talk of literacy and the money they are worth.
So the question you see is,
you'll have more competitors there, sir. It is not in your interest.
But why you wanted to know about this Indian village?
You see, has this wealth that I see in any way affected them? That's all that I am interested in. Is it circulating to the common man there? What is his condition today? I have always had a great regard for the intelligence of the Indian peasant, uneducated. I tell you, my grandmother, I learned more from her all about Vedanta than all the professors in the university put together. She knew only how to sign her name or read some books, because she listened to all these pundits, learned people. The way she explained to me that the world is not an illusion. And there these people are harangued there in the university. She explained the world is not an illusion. If somebody comes with a gun and you see you have to react, that's not an illusion. You see, the illusion is, the thought is the maya, she said. The maya is to measure. She picked up these things from those discourses there in our place, is to measure. So there must be a point here, and from this you measure things. So anything you experience of that world is an illusion.
This measurement is an illusion.
This measurement is an illusion because it is creating. She did not use the word space. So anything you experience of the world is an illusion. You don't know a thing about the world, you can't say that the world is an illusion. If somebody comes with a gun to shoot you, you have to duck or run away, otherwise you are a fool. You can't say that it is. This is similar, she used. So I listened to Dr. Mahadevan there, you see, hours and hours, talking about the Mayavada or Sakshivada. What rubbish? Huh? What rubbish?
to what do you attribute?
There is a culture is not just reading and writing. It's a way of life and a way of thinking. That is the culture. In that sense, I use the word. They are very cultured people, these villagers, and very much impressed.
Very.
Very much
they
impressed.
They were so refined.
So refined, so
the boy coming and saying, thank you very much for the money. He coming, don't worry. They were very decent.
He knew that, you see, we were not there to give charity.
Charity, it just happened.
It was something spontaneous. Something spontaneous, you see, when those people, they did not even ask for money. Okay. I suggested that the next thing that they want is money.
So you going to the village and seeing all these things, is it not on the part of your hypocrisy?
My hypocrisy or their hypocrisy? Why is it hypocrisy?
Like you know,
I want to know.
Like a chiriya, you see, you know intuitively how they came to the village.
No, I didn't know. I didn't have a chance to go there any time. I walked through this big city. It's there, I am there, you see, in Bangalore only, in the big city. But where is this wealth? You see, I am tremendously impressed by the wealth of the people there. So has it in any way touched, you see, the people, the common mass of people?
He has been asking for several years.
Several years I have been asking.
I want to see the Indian village.
Some village, typical
I want Indian to see village. A typical Indian village where
so that I can have
I know
an
for
idea.
Myself.
He had, you know, a big bundle of 100 rupees.
No, many people say this. People who go to villages, they say, many people say, who are in higher status, the people in villages are very intelligent. It's a very common thing.
It may be a common thing, but your wanting, you see, to do anything to them, is hypocrisy. I am not going to do anything for them. I am not going to do anything for him. I am going to do anything for him. So I am not impressed by this great big talk of illiteracy and also doing something like San Pedro, what is his name, the author of the television, saying we are going to spend so many millions of rupees. By all means, we spend millions and millions of people. He is going to read that Indian Express paper or the Hindu paper here, and that will influence his thinking. So you are only interested in winning their votes, brainwashing them. Sir, what do you have anything to say other than what you read in the newspaper? On any issue, political issue, maybe in your nothing. He reads Indian Express, I read Hindu. This is a conversation between the Hindu and Indian Express. You and I have nothing to say. Nothing. I have nothing to say. I have been curious. You see, when I listen to the talk there in the West that India is a poor country, I don't see any poverty here. The country I grew up in, you see, was quite different. When I see all these women going there, you see, in I see only poor people. That's why I'm curious to see.
You're saying, how wanting to do anything about it is hypocrisy.
It is hypocrisy.
So what I'm saying is, very
your strange. Interest is to educate them in a way to, you see, to work in your favor.
No, I can see the profit motive here. You see, what I can see his point. You see, you actually don't want anything from them. But
no.
Even
I won't do anything for them.
No, but my writing,
either.
Even if I write about it,
I am not moved. I am not going.
The profit
to
motive is here.
You see, that is something which you cannot change.
This is a profit motive.
Yes.
But there is not here. This is the hypocrisy is there in us. It's not there in him.
Not in me.
See, my wanting to write about it is hypocrisy.
My little finger to help them at all.
Yes. Yes.
My want, even wanting to write about it is hypocrisy.
No, I am not calling it make money out of the misery of somebody.
Exactly. So you have to make...
You make a movie out of the
movie
misery of somebody. By
article,
all means do it.
Movie, fame, article, a politician, vote, whatever you do, you get something
exploitation.
Out of it.
No, don't use those words.
There's something you're getting out of it.
Not, don't call it hypocrisy. Don't call it exploitation. He is using them.
Using that.
You see, you use somebody. I am not saying anything against using.
What about the missionaries who go there with all affection,
very clear they wanted
compassion?
They were interested only in converting people.
Converting.
And
see,
that was
something
it.
New.
Only converting people.
You want to write about it.
Yeah.
You're getting something. You're getting something out of it.
You are using that poor hungry man.
That is, I can
or
see
a
point.
Starving cow
no,
there.
No, my visit is implicit. I don't know.
I did not expect to go there at all.
We just went either by accident.
By accident we went there and these boys, little boys gathered. wronged us. We knew that they were there only for money, but it happened to be, turned out to be something different.
Dr. Chandrasekhar.
If I broke pebbles, that's all right. It was something.
If there was only pebbles,
that's fine.
1923.
And then you see, we were 1925.
27 years.
That is the golden jubilee.
65 years later, you're telling me the choice is awareness is what a dog's
at. Yes.
Same beat, 65 years later, you tell me. How can you do that?
That is the dog is choicelessly aware. That's not, but that's something that you cannot use to bring about a change in you. So now they have come to tell us that there is no such thing as awareness at all. It is an activity of the soul. It cannot be separated from it and used as an instrument to bring about any change. That's why I call Christ, the fraud of the 20th century. You see, he put us all on the wrong track, but he gave us this beautiful language, a new slang.
Yes.
He used, even I used reluctantly many of these, because I did psychology also. The part of the language it has become, but as I said from late, that he who has falsified the case history to establish a theory, something which is not actually. Anyway, it is losing the.
Yes. His own research was contradicting him later. That wasn't stuff.
Anyway, he survived for 100 years less. Anything that lasts that long must be good. Must have something. You live in Besant Nagar?
Yes.
On the way, after the Elliot Beach Road, where is Besant Nagar exactly?
The old Elliot Beach.
Elliot Beach.
That is.
You have a lot of buildings there. We went there last time.
We have about 6,000 families there.
Really?
Can you recognize him?
This is Air India Kumar.
Yes.
Kumar. Yeah. I couldn't place
him. He came with.
Last time we came here.
Not here. There in Madras.
Yes, the last time.
I can't forget faces.
Ah.
But I can't
remember
names. That has been my problem.
I can't forget faces, but I can't remember names.
And also what we talked, I can reproduce. Exactly. In the way. And our telephone is here.
So,
please call me in Telugu, so I'm answering in Telugu. No salt, no spices.
Why?
Because that is part of my spiritual sadhana. Unfortunately. I had great difficulty to.
Part that right, you know, Shivananda told it.
No, forget it, sir. Shivananda, forget it. I will have to. Well, what do you call that? You want your belief. That's not the way to control. You will be surprised that you will have no control afterwards. All this struggle, I really don't have any control. You see, once there was 1.5 kilos of almonds. I ate them all, 1.5 kilos. This old lady in front of mine, this lady, she would hide them. What are you doing? I did the same thing in Delhi this time. Pistachio. One pound of them, they finally took that away from me. But are you doing it? Of course, I may have to pay the price. The body can take care of it. It will draw all what is not necessary. But this, so, body does not need to know anything, does not need to learn. Whatever intelligence that is necessary for its survival is already there, and we don't have to learn. That's why when I see some nutritionist, I tell them, put them on site at study. Because I don't eat vegetables, I don't eat fruits, I drink 1.5 liters of cream every day. What is the point of those people telling me that you will have cholesterol? There were all those who advised me and lived on strict nutritional, preached the nutritional wisdom, and ate only nutritional food, they are all dead and gone. I'm still here. Even the astrologer, there is a verse he quoted. That planetary position, what is the word? Mitabhojan.
Mitabhojan.
He is very little.
శివరాత్రి
నో
దట్ నెక్స్ట్ డే ఐ పెయింట్ ది ప్రైస్ బాడీ పెయింట్ ది ప్రైస్
చూడాలని వచ్చి పాపన్ అవర్ రీల్డ్ అవుట్ జ్ఞాన చక్రవర్తి
వాట్ అదర్ రీసెర్చ్ యూ హ్యావ్ డన్ ఇన్ టు మై చార్ట్ నాడి
The question is, why you don't totally reject, why you don't totally reject everything I am saying? Saying that is absolutely rubbish that is talking
and
walk away. If you accept what I am saying, partially or totally, is it because you see some parallels in what I am saying and what the framework you have, whether it is Vedanta or Krishnamurti or religious framework? So I asked him a question. What was his answer? What is your answer? Now he is here.
Oh,
he wants it for the article.
ఆర్టికల్ లో ఉన్నాయి
సార్. Yes, he wants, sir.
He wants to find a parallels or not. I am not concerned with those parallels or statements at all. I told him, a sincere, sadhaka if he is sincere, sometimes he touches the vital parts. He cannot.
You said?
Touches the vital parts.
So he cannot reject.
A real, serious, sincere sadhana. Sadhana means an aspirant, one who...
A real aspirant. Cannot reject.
Cannot?
Okay. Because now and then it touches the vital parts.
Now and then?
Does it make any sense? No.
It does.
If I were in that situation, I suddenly get involved. Never see man.
100%.
Because you don't know what you're talking about. It doesn't make any sense to me. Because I don't have any reference point. I walk, but good. Never see it. Why are you? Careful. No, I want to make it very clear to myself.
Put it in a operative way. Sometimes you did it right away. Sometimes you just throw them overboard.
Illogical, irrational, and inconceivable.
Coffee you want, Mahesh?
No.
I can prepare it for you.
I want an answer to this question. Why was I open?
Maybe something useful for the
Why is all you?
Very good. Determined swastika. Tranquil on
it.
That is just an event. Links them all up together to create a story.
The teaching for prosperity.
I don't see any reason why the story of my life should be any time. Some reference, you see, you can make after so many years. If you ask questions about the Gita,
man can only understand one language, that is what he means, what value
of particular three acts. It is but natural that the motive of everybody who comes to see you, everybody that is around you, wants to use you for his or her benefit.
Right. Not what, excuse me, what I am saying.
What do you say?
That's all. The distinction you are making between what I am saying and what I am. And then how can you use me, what I am? Have any fishing boat can I? They are returning.
Yes.
Returning back home. All the water. All the body.
And they all have motors, where are they? Any subject, I think.
And it took you time to master that.
It was, of course. I used three models. One Radha Krishna. One Mr. Jini Rajadas, I think, a very profound scholar. He is style like a thesis. And the third one was the Sarasvati Ramaswamy Iyer, who spoke on any subject. Any subject. Just not an ordinary. Any subject, music, philosophy, architecture, politics, everything.
He was the Vice Chancellor. At that time,
Vice Chancellor of Namara University. Not Madras. Then later on.
When I.
He was the Divan of Travancore State.
For the 2 years. There was many people who wrote in Madras who were very angry.
Yes, all the Vyasa case to Krishnamurti preached. 800, 900
old men. If you do not know, you are lost. Stay away from him.
Advising him.
Very angry letters. Some people said, I knew him.
That was Nataraj.
Nataraj.
Yeah. I see.
He met the same Rao. Yes. You don't know, you have to see him.
Which Rao?
Our doctor, Seshagiri
Rao.
Yes. He was a close friend of us in those days. He was very close in those days. Krishnamurti is great. You have to see this man, UG, but not...
Yes, I don't know.
Misled by...
I met some of his old colleagues in here, in Kalakshetra. They all were a lot of venomous. I don't know, even Shankara Menon, because he has nothing to say about you. Shankar Menon, yes. There is nothing, but he didn't say much. Shankar Menon is the only person who spoke very wildly. He never talked anything. But Krishna Ratna was very venomous. I don't know why. And there was another person also I met there. He also said he met you. He was in the library.
Seshachalam. Seshatri? No, I don't know. I don't even know them, Sensei.
So why do you write to me letters?
Not to you.
To me.
To the editor.
No, to me.
Yes.
This Tatwa is something. Wrong letters.
Yeah, they want some outlet for themselves. Somebody attacks Krishnamurti.
Actually, they should attack you.
They don't.
They are attacking me.
Yes, because you have written an article on me. I did not write that one. You allowed yourself, you see, to be
influenced by this man.
Yeah. That he wants, they want to save
he
you.
He wants to influence me, the Bhagavad.
They want to save you from me.
Ah, this man. This is Tumulapalli. Tamalingeshwar Rao. Yeah, so there's nothing. No, no, he was not, he thinks too much, but that book is nothing there. And I know him since my beginning days. I was telling him, when I gave him. Of course, it only reveals their shallowness. But this man...
It only reveals their anger.
So what?
So you want to put me on a level of thousands of people deserting their wives in America every day, walking away. All right, it's fine with me. And even Krishnamurti wanted to discuss, why you are detaching yourself, sir? Why you are not attached to yourself? What the hell you are talking? I am not here to discuss attachment, detachment with you, Mr. You know?
But you said once that earlier you never liked the children, little children. And now that seems to be the only difference.
Not, I mean, like in the sense that, you see, I don't know. I never went out of the way kissing babies and showing.
Even something. Now you don't, sir. But
no.
Children are naturally attracted to you.
Yeah.
But then, at that time, it was not there.
I was not an exhibitionist of anything, you see. So why you are always comparing Chandrasekhar? Tell me.
There seems to be
what
some.
What is there behind this
the question.
Attempt on your part?
What?
I am telling you consistently that.
What is he saying to
there
you?
Is no. You see, there is something you are always trying before and after wash. You want to use the.
See, sir, the problem is with you.
Why?
Why did the hell did you say to us? This, you went through this metamorphosis, change in body, plans, this thing.
That was in response to some idiot's question.
But they were printed.
All right. Yes,
so the natural, over. When people...
I am telling you now, you are a damn fool to buy that book and read it.
you
have put it in the paper. He who buys this book needs must be a damn fool. I mean it.
Why did you say right about that?
What? In response to some questions, I explained
it's
to you.
It's natural
why.
For a person like.
Not right, you see, that was the time when the whole gang of Krishnamurti people started descending on me. So I had to tell them there is nothing psychological about this. Then I realized it is neither psychological nor physiological. These are the effects or the fallout, you see, of whatever happened, which cannot be interpreted, you see, in religious terms at all. Which must not be, cannot be, and should not be interpreted in religious terms.
First you explain this, you say, you elaborately talk about what happened, then you say, that did something happen?
So what?
Of course it happened!
Why, what happened? I don't know what happened, and has anything happened, I said on the television.
Yes, but something did happen!
Why you want to quote that, you see, yesterday's stuff I'm saying now, has anything happened? But why you want to stick to that? You tell me.
Because it's natural for him to ask.
No. There is. Why is this question bothering you guys?
Otherwise they won't be around you. Why are we here?
Huh? Why you are bothered about, you see, that Ramana Maharshi, I am calling him a bastard, filthy bastard, Krishnamurti, is a phony.
Actually,
why you want, you see, to believe that he still helped me? Or you call this anger, you are mad and you are still connected with that man, you have not freed yourself from that. You are the one that is throwing all this garbage all the time.
No, question.
Yeah, yes,
actually,
you
don't
you
care a damn about what Krishna
I don't care.
Even the first, I don't think that. Maybe he cares. Question is not even of Krishna. Question is.
Or Ramana Maharshi.
Question personally for me is not of this.
Then what is it then?
Question is.
What is it? What is your problem?
Problem.
What's your problem?
The problem?
Then why are you asking me? You must have done something. Forget about all those people. Forget about all those people getting angry. You see, they can't even believe that this fellow who was with you all of a sudden is somewhere.
No, he's asking.
He was not considered to be even a candidate.
Things before and after.
You know? It was just like any
so
one of us.
You have
suddenly
said about something happened to
yes.
you.
Huh? He deserted his wife, he walked
you
away.
Have
he
to
did
say,
this, he did that. How can this man be?
Yeah.
Huh?
You are also.
How can he talk against that fellow, you see, whom he also listened like with us?
See, this is absurd. What? You yourself were saying in 1967, I died.
Yes,
are you asking yourself, how? Why do you keep on talking about things before 1967?
Why you are talking
You
about
say for the first time amidst us, in this world is a man who says, I died in 1967, but he is still here.
That's so your problem.
It obviously is a problem, that's why we are asking.
So you have no way. To resolve this problem,
you can
figure out, try, you see, for the rest of your life.
Nobody amidst us, if he says, in 1967 I died,
that was the end. Don't talk anything about it more.
Difference is nothing?
Yes, sir. The question is idiotic to ask. You are asking an idiotic question based upon the knowledge you have of the behaviors and movements and actions of a living man. The question is born out of that. If you ask me, are you alive? Certainly I would say I am alive. Because I have the same knowledge that you have about, you see, the definition of a living man. But what I am saying is, there is no way I can tell myself that I am alive, that I am awake, that I am asleep or dreaming. No way. I can't say this is me. You seem to be able to say that this is me. That's your problem.
That is the problem.
Yeah, that's your problem. Stay with that problem. I'm not here to free you from that.
Sir, but this kind of state which you are saying now, that I'm not aware that it's me and so on.
Yes.
Would it not be another deluded state?
Why, you see, my delusion, why are you interested in becoming a part of my, or you want to be, you free me from my delusion? What is the idea?
No, the idea is to...
I'm telling you, you get lost, I don't care for you guys. He says, this is what I'm saying. Take it or leave. Huh? Don't bother about me.
So we don't bother about you.
No,
we are bothered about ourselves.
Yes.
We have no illusion that we are bothered about you.
You go there. Good luck to you. Yeah?
Babuji, you're hiding behind the coming face of my caste.
That this man who spoke died to you yesterday was as romantic, as nostalgic as me, and before death he goes to every spot, every corner, every...
That is what you are interested in, that's why you want to take me to the peace office
exactly.
Of the society,
yeah.
And you want me to show you where I lived, I see what I did and all that kind of thing. I am telling you that there is no story. His last walk, first walk, he impressed you all. And the fellow Joker talking, died you were yesterday.
Yes.
There is no teaching, no teacher, no thought. And all your life, your only interest is how to preserve the teaching for posterity. In its pristine purity. Come on, sir. You are that dumb. You have some intelligence left there. I'm sorry. It's a reflection on your intelligence. You still believe that there is something to you.
Sir, he is behaving like lovers, like me and my wife, and we go out and we say, darling, remember we met here so many years ago. Same thing. How can you say on the platform, died here yesterday, and in real life you're going there? How can you tell to Babu, and you say, I do not know Yogi Krishnamurti? And yes, Babu says he's a great guy. So what he's saying is, why isn't, on what basis are we, really have we not, but, on what basis is this reference from?
On what basis? And all these jokers that are coming from the tenth, the biggest thing, from Pune, why should they come to me? I'm not asking them to
come. We form the opinions and the images.
No, exactly. He said, we are up to in prison and when we are taking this document, right?
Yes.
For me there is no recall. And I said, why? I have nothing but recall. Me, I have nothing but a recall.
Yes.
He said, there is no recall for me. It has no, this spot that you're making me stand next to, the power of taking a shot. It means nothing. I only say that that's how I lived it. But you are connecting it and you're trying to give it importance.
I never looked at that. I never went back, I never will go there. If tomorrow these books are burnt, I will be the first one to join them. You ask me that question, what would happen if the book is burnt? I will be the first one. If they say don't talk, I won't talk. I'm not a missionary, I'm not going to be a martyr. Not that I'm frightened. I'm not a missionary here, I'm not here to say, burn those books. If they say don't talk, you are a threat, fine. I go and watch my television or something else.
What a threat.
You got where?
You see, Yuji, then what?
Come on.
Where when I go and look at the
bench in Nehru's studio when I was assisting director and sit down and discuss cinema. I give that importance because at this given moment I have within me a feeling of importance that I have
today.
In relation to that point, I am a somebody today and people are around me, people listen to me, people take my interviews. So I definitely have this feeling of importance right now. Because of that, I go and give that particular chair importance. So you, I don't think...
Are they burned that chair?
You, I don't know, you say one of the... I don't think you feel at any time that you are in possession of something great.
No.
Which we don't seem to understand. Because I am all the time...
No, but instead of you see, stopping there, I really don't know, I can't figure out. Why you are trying to defend something which you really... Here is the money, Valentine. Jump out of that window.
You don't
feel... Yeah, see, no, you don't seem to understand.
I don't see.
And even Eddie was telling me, why you are doing all this for Valentine?
You don't feel at this given moment that you have, you are in possession of something which is great. Do you feel anything?
No.
That's the problem. I give importance to that because... In relation to that point, I feel I have got something
all right, but
very valuable now.
All right, that's all
so
right.
That thing is not important.
That is all right. Why do you want, you see, to me to do that?
Because we can't figure out.
Yes.
How can you be different?
I am saying that I am not different. You are saying that I am different.
No, if you are different,
yes,
then you will also be like us. You will not be like us. If you are,
then why are you asking me to do those things?
Because we are not finding
like
that.
Persons like him, if you are not different from him, he would like to do like that. They
we are obviously are different.
No, no. The question of difference does not at all arise here. Why do you want me to go through that nonsensical thing of going there? I live at this house. I showed only, you see, to point out. You see, that's how we are going there. So where you sat here, where the pebbles you collected, I am not interested in that at all. I know, the factual memory I have. That's why I'm talking about it. I'm not involved.
You see, that memory has no importance unless I fix this point at this given moment. Today, after 60 years, when I walk with you, Mr. Murthy, on this beach, I'm walking with a marvelous man who was a kid yesterday. Unless, you see, that all, if I call you, I will think that the whole, I have to fix various points back.
So what is the problem?
There's no problem.
There is a problem obviously here.
You seem to resent.
I don't, now you see, now you are taking this line, I don't resent. I'm pointing out the absurdity of you wanting me to go there and sit under the banyan tree. Under the banyan tree you give some lectures there. You did that, you sat there, you see, what are you talking? I am telling you all that is irrelevant. Either you accept it or you don't accept it. To you it is irrelevant, to me it is irrelevant. So there is no basis of any understanding on that. To me it is irrelevant. I have added to the list even Valentine. And after that there is no story. No story to tell. What can you tell? He was there in Bombay, he's here, he talked this, you can record it. You see, even that I don't want.
The sense of achievement is totally absent in you.
That's what I'm saying.
You see, for you, you are like a person who leaves a room of a five-star hotel.
Finish.
I was in room number 703.
That's all.
I go out.
No,
you don't go back and say, I was here and let's go back to the hotel. Let's go and look at the bed where you were. This was the bathroom where I had a shower. So, for you, everything, all the incidents are as...
Just some series of events. So, I'm not interested in linking up those things and creating a story. Or interpret those events.
We're looking at the human drama in terms of high points. Points. And that's how we build up a story. Yeah.
You big, high-sounding
story. High point!
Drama. What human drama?
The story!
I don't see any... Maybe in the movie you have a
that's
human
what I'm
drama.
Trying to say. Story!
I don't see any drama in your life. You are a pathetic individual. Miserable individual. All the time fighting.
inside of you, battle, war. You can't live with another human being. And you talk of humanity.
Yeah.
Hey, come on, sir. The drama is all right, movie. It's a sad story. A 60-year-old man, 80-year-old man who listened to the Joker.
So what you said?
At least they are honest.
What did you say? I can't live with another human being.
Human being. You can't live with yourself.
And I say I'm concerned about humanity.
You can't live with yourself. With the woman you love, you say. You can't live with that woman.
Hey.
Sad story it is. And you want to make a big thing out of that. You can't live with yourself. Not another woman, because you cannot live with yourself. Let alone living with another.
No, already recorded.
Is there?
Recorded
already. Then repeat it, it's recorded.
Go on, Mr. Mahesh.
Take care, I think. This Bechain, what do you call
restlessness
was there in me.
Yes,
before listening to.
Restlessness is bound to be there all the time. And you were looking for some philosophy to find out why you are...
In fact, I wasn't looking. I was stumbled upon these people, let's say. I wasn't looking for these people.
No, but the restlessness needed an explanation for you. A philosophy justified or to resolve the problem of restlessness. The restlessness is there because of that, not whether it is Rajneesh or Jai Krishnamurti or Yogi Krishnamurti, or doesn't matter what it is.
Yes.
It's the variations are the same.
The restlessness
so
is
that, that has,
a,
it,
but the restlessness in the way is good.
It's a good thing.
It is not that these people created restlessness in me. It was there already in me.
But why is it there? Because of that.
No, that's what I'm saying. Not because of that. Even before that.
No, see, there can't be any restlessness unless there is a goal.
Yeah, there's a goal.
To be achieved.
And in life, we have to have a goal.
If you say we have to have a goal, you
some
see,
kind
the
of
restlessness is altogether an irrelevant subject. You see, because they go together. As long as you have a goal of becoming something, achieving something, attaining something, accomplishing something, there is bound
to be restless.
Restlessness. So you are trying to find a solution for this and not freeing yourself from that goal. That's what I am saying. So these people have providing you with explanations and solutions for your restlessness.
The problem is goal.
What child I am?
No. नहीं ये ले जाइए. ये ले जाइए आप.
चाय बना कर लाइए भाई.
जी सर लाता
हूँ. क्या ला रहे हो चाय? हमको भी ले पिलाओ फिर. अब इनको पिला रहे हो हमको भी पिलाओ. बत्ती ऑन कर दो भाई. इकबाल भाई. बत्ती ऑन कर दो. अंधेरे में डर लगता है हमको.
अच्छा वो जनरेटर चालू करते हैं.
बत्ती नहीं है अभी.
नहीं लाइट चली गई.
चलिए अच्छा फिर ठीक है आ जाओ.
In this complex world, to live without a goal looks to be an impossibility. Even little goal.
Yeah, why are you
it's
trying,
practically
sir?
Impossible.
Why are you trying, sir?
Huh?
Why are you trying? Even if, as you say, you don't think that it is impossible. You are made to believe by all these people that there is some way you can free yourself from restlessness.
Yes.
Every one of them.
Yes.
So here some chapter comes along and says it is not the restlessness that is the problem. The goal that you should be free from restlessness. That is the problem.
No, so I am asking, is it ever possible to be free of goal? Okay, your standpoint is this, that you should be free from the goal.
That question is a dangerous question because you have to drop day. We go back to
that. So the goal... To be free from the goal becomes the other goal.
Is it ever possible? Yeah, it's another goal.
Yes, whatever you
He says that the only way you can be free from the goal is by dropping dead.
Then you see you are asking me how to free myself from the goal.
From the goal.
Yes.
So I'm not going to tell you there is no way you can free. The only way you can free yourself
from the goal is drop dead.
Is to drop dead.
that doesn't drop dead means...
That's all. Then he is asking me, are you dead? How do you know that you are dead? You see, the whole story. Then you will know yourself. I don't have to tell you and you don't have to ask me the question.
So everything goes back to the point, death.
Death.
So you are not interested, we don't want to die, so we continue with our restlessness.
That's all.
How can a living being be interested in death? Tell me. It's an unnatural thing.
So don't try to be free from death.
How can you be interested in
death?
So what we are looking for is solution
why
to our restlessness.
Why do you accept the story that you
while we live,
listen,
while we
Mr. Mahesh Bhatt?
Yes.
Why did you listen to the crap of that man like you were yesterday? Why
I think this.
Huh? Why?
Because it... it
that is
no,
so.
No, no, because I think he gives me the solution, the imaginary solution to my problem that I can die and be alive and be free of my restlessness.
Good luck to you.
Isn't it? That's what we want.
Alive
that's
more correct. Richly.
Yeah.
Not ordinarily.
That's the hope that gives. Not only he. Sometimes Yuji also gives the hope. Not whenever you look at him, that it is possible to live like him.
No. He doesn't give you that hope.
No, he is. But you see, when he sees, when we see him, when we move with him, somehow we are hooked to this hope. That we can also one day be with him.
No,
it is possible to imitate him in his the manner in which about he goes about his daily activity of handling things.
Mm.
Not in any other way. Like the way he writes, the way he... We can only steal from him in those areas, the way he handles things. That also very, very, very limited. I don't think that is...
No, only
it is impossible.
Those areas.
So can
only
this
those areas,
death can be cultivated?
Only areas. But in
gradually, no.
Every time you give that...
By reason, by intellectual perception.
It can be delayed.
What?
Can be delayed? No, the death,
the
so called this death, can it be cultivated, I said, by and by?
No.
Not possible.
It
because
can be delayed through genetic engineering.
Forget about
you
genetic engineering.
There is no other way.
Genetic engineering, that is all.
No, don't say that. Don't
you have forget
that.
About
if
that.
If for any reason you want to prolong, that's the only way. There is no other way. Why you want to keep alive forever, eternally, is a different matter. If that is what you want, that's the only way. There is no other way. That means you want the restlessness to go on forever.
But you see, what he was saying yesterday in the car to me, what I said, Yuji, for some strange reason, in spite of you being so normal and so friendly, there is this feeling of inferiority that I have when I'm with you. He says you want to be inferior because you want to be superior in your world, like you want to be
take
like Mr. Satyajit today.
Take for example.
You are struggling to become like the top director of the country. You are not yet. So you want to become like Mr. Ray. So you feel that if you get this, then you will be the top. You'll be the top. While solution to your problem is there, if you go and struggle there, then you can become.
Mm-hmm. So you are trying via media.
No, you want this. You see, you want because you want to be superior.
Mm-hmm.
You as long as you want to be superior. You feel inferior to me. But I said, God, my position, I'm taking my position junior to him, lower to him, at his feet, putting him up on my altar, calling him my God, calling him the man that from whom I've drawn everything, is a strategical device to become like him, or to get what he is there.
Not like me, to get
that, I mean, which
that
is,
one.
That, like you means the idea of what transformation is. So what he's saying is a solution, that restlessness that is there in us can be controlled, can be handled in our workaday world by being successful.
Mm-hmm.
But the question is, be successful all the time.
But there's a price for that.
Yeah, there's a price for that.
No, to be successful is not easy again.
There is a price for that. You have to be all the time.
Mortgage yourself. Mortgage, practically.
You have to.
Yeah.
There is no other way.
There is no other way.
And these people are selling you shoddy piece of
you. You have to dedicate yourself to that competition.
Well,
all the time training.
When you give up, don't make a virtue of that one. That is also easy. You say that I don't want it to come to the competition. Let them be superior. I don't want to be superior.
That's the only way we can give up, sir.
Yesterday, when I asked the driver to sit with us, and this joker was resenting the whole thing all the time, brahmacharya.
Yeah.
You remember yesterday?
Yeah.
In the restaurant?
Yeah.
And he was feeling bad.
Yeah.
And this fellow also was feeling bad. Both of them were.
His advice is to give up music.
I'm not asking you to give up.
Yes.
You will not give up, he says.
You will not give up. You see, you give up only when you are offered something better.
Yes.
What they have offered as something better, he's not genuine article, that's all that I'm saying. That is why it has not worked. Not only it has not worked, it's taking away tremendous amount of energy which you need to deal with the problem there. You don't have the energy there. That needs tremendous energy.
Energy, yes. So achievement
that
is the only thing that you're left.
Consumed by you are wanting
achieve,
to be
all the time.
A transformed individual. If you were transformed, you would handle the things differently. That is why that is no problem for me.
So you meant to say people in the world who are not at all informed about this aspect of things, who are struggling, they are
struggling to be happy always. That fisherman there,
yeah,
he wants to be happy permanently. He wants to have pleasure all the time. He wants to have everything. Like you, he is no different, you see. So that is not any different from you. Mm-hmm. What you want here also is permanent happiness and permanent pleasure. Your transformation is an extension of pleasure. Your self-realization is an extension of pleasure. He doesn't call it pleasure, but it is the same. God is an extension of your pleasure.
See, you say that, many times you said that you never question your actions. You act only to that moment. And you never question your actions.
Before or after?
Before or after.
No.
So that situation, many times it's I feel that I wish I could be in that situation. Because
that becomes a model.
That becomes a model.
Another model.
It's not possible.
Because it's transformation.
Because there is no action without questioning. Questioning is thinking the pros and cons. Which action will be beneficial to me? If something goes wrong, you regret afterwards. This is all that is there for me. There is only one action. There are no two there for me. So how can I regret afterwards? Something went wrong, forget it. And I don't use this to correct my actions next time. So this cannot be a model for you.
Yeah, but in my life, to manipulate the events in life, I think that this could be of some help if this tool comes to me.
What I am telling is you cannot manipulate the events because the events are outside your control.
పెళ్ళి అయితే కానీ పిచ్చుకు రోజు తీసుకుంటే స్విచ్కు తెచ్చుతారు పెళ్లి కాదు
ఇన్ తెలుగు యూ కెనాట్ గెట్ మ్యారీడ్ అన్లెస్ యూఆర్ ఫ్రీ ఫ్రమ్ యువర్ మ్యాడ్నెస్
అన్లెస్
మ్యాడ్నెస్
అన్లెస్ హీఈస్ క్యూర్డ్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ మ్యాడ్నెస్
There is no way you can marry.
And unless he gets married, you cannot be cured of his madness. Where is the solution for it?
He ran away, that is Brahmachari. Brahmachari ran away.
Where are you going?
Walk. Pathetic individual. Now begins the humidity again. Stickiness.
Look at that. Beautiful girl who came, that South Indian lady was there, this fair girl, simple girl sitting down there. When she was staring at you, she had this doped, glazed look in her eyes. And she was constantly staring at you. It was there in the dentist who was staring at you. It was there in the petrified violinist who was staring at you. It, to every eye was there, the assumption is staring at you.
And they all listen to the politician there.
No, that's because they have been told that he is a transformer. Supposing they had met him on the street, just like that. You think they would have stared at him like that?
No. I'm saying that. But there's also a difference. Today when we go for a walk down to this village, the children come, maybe you can find, call him an animal, a pretty, like you see a lovely hairy dog. So a child goes and plays with a hairy dog or a beautiful, cow. So the children come and they snuggle next to him, and that fisherman talks endlessly and empties his heart out to him for some reason. And that's why I can understand that he feels more comfortable with contact with people like that, because there are no assumptions, but they feel comfortable.
That's a different thing, but they are not looking at him as a ave like that.
Yeah.
Like these people are looking, dazed. That is because of knowledge they have got about him. Why people is Rajani, you have seen in Rajani Shastra, no? How people... Huh?
That same name is Abhiya, sir.
Yeah. That's that.
And you can get any kind of experience if you want to.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
If you want to listen to experience, spiritual experience, the best place to go is to Puttaparthi. Talk to the people. White fields of Puttaparthi. Everybody had an experience. Weird, some. I don't know how they are getting all
this. I think he encourages you.
Huh?
He must be encouraging it.
They encourage you, sir.
Yeah.
Light, low light, gray, all kinds of colors.
He was encouraging, but some of these commentaries on living. What is that? Living? Commentaries on living? Sir, you have understood that, sir. It's a joke, it's a theater. Now, how can you take this seriously, that stuff? You don't seem to understand. That fellow, writing about California in Madras, about Madras in Switzerland, the description of the scene, he was not writing here. Months after that, he's writing about the sea waves and all that, sitting somewhere there in Sanand.
That's a device. Like, it's like me, tomorrow I'll go back to Bombay and write.
Exactly. It's a poet talking about that nonsense, you see, describing. That's not the way, you see, he cannot describe, you see. If as he says, look at that, he cannot describe the sunset.
Creates an impression that he is looking every detail there, he is not missing anything in front of him.
I am also describing.
J.K.
There is a world of difference between my description and his description. I am also describing what is going on.
Yeah.
But
he was describing what he was describing.
Beautiful, all this.
What did I say about this, sir?
Yeah, but there was not this ecstatic staring and, oh my God, a divine moment is slipping out of your hand. Mm-hmm. You see, there you are being met. A divine moment is just going past you, and you're not something. You're missing it. That seems to be the cry there.
Wasted fright. He fooled you all. He didn't fool me.
Don't accept that. You go one step further and tell me. Tell yourself and tell me. That he helped me. I am saying no, and you want to believe that he helped me.
We are right.
Why? How do you resolve this situation? I want to know. That you are the man that he is talking about. The transformation. You may say what you like, do what you like, put it in whatever way you like. But that is what he is talking about, that is what you are, and he helped you. I say no. I am neither that transformed individual, nor he helped me. What?
Yeah. And assuming he did help you, why wouldn't you tell us that?
Then Rajneesh says, I am hiding the fact.
You would tell us that.
He's hiding the fact.
Which fact that they
For what?
That I
will help
to Krishnamurti, that I say that I knew him so well. I am all the time talking about it, that joker, you see. Sits on a platform and tells some cock and bull stories. And there are 1,000 people or 10,000 people ready to listen to that. What is it that you are saying?
No, I said, if he did really help you, I wouldn't think that you would tell us. You would tell us that yes, he did help me.
Yes.
Why would you suppress this fact that yes, somebody helped me? Somebody helped me do this. Somebody helped me get this house. Somebody helped me go buy me a ticket. Like you say about everything else, you would have also said that yes, he helped me.
She helped me, she came,
put up all the money in my this thing.
Yes, and all that I'm telling you.
If you have said that, which people find rather embarrassing, oh my God, how does Yuji live? Oh, there was this lady who put all the money. Mm-hmm. When you are not hesitant enough at all to say that, why would you hesitate to say that? No, this is the generator. Both are the same thing, usually. Because I believe that there is something like transformation. Because of J. Krishnamurti or whoever it is, I believe that you are a transformed man. Because if I did not believe you are a transformed man, I wouldn't be around you. And the next thing is automatic, that he helped you to get transformed. Because if I don't say that, then it knocks out the possibility of you helping me to get transformed.
Exactly. He set himself up in the business of telling everybody that I am here to help you guys.
from me and return to me. See, what I am saying is not that I am going to help those guys have not helped. That's the business tactics. You sell your cigarettes. That was Krishnamurti's line. All the traditional nonsense, all the bills are frauds. I am the only one. See, I am telling you that look here, buddy, there is nothing there to be transformed. That is why he is a phony.
Yes. Yes.
Not only they, forget about they. This fellow who has set up himself up in a business, saying that he is the teaching, that there is a radical transformation. I blast that fellow not because he is a phony, but because this is the phony one. He is selling a phony piece. So how can I put myself up on a higher pedestal and tell you that they did not help, he did not help, I can help you. I am not for a moment saying that I can help you. See, my cigarettes are better than those cigarettes. Look here, buddy, there is nothing there to be helped. Please, nothing to have to be changed. If you don't want to listen to me, go back and enjoy. I don't miss you. I don't miss anybody. Are they ever the girl?
Monday.
You tell me, Mr. Mayesh, but we don't waste any more time together. Together, let us go. No.
Together, let us go. Let us take a journey.
No. No, journey. Then why do you still persist that it helped me? Then my visit with Ramana Maharshi, with that Krishnamurti, it helped me. Why? I am telling you, no, no. Why?
Because that seems to be the hope for us.
You don't want to take my word.
We don't take your word.
All right. So why the hell you are here?
Because we are not concerned.
Why you are listening to the rest of it and not
because
that
because he is not concerned with your words or your statements. Yeah. He is concerned with you, therefore he is here.
No.
I am concerned with my hope.
It is
you have nothing to do with it.
But there is another place where you are given tremendous
hope. I prune you, I cut you to fit you into my hope.
Listen, there are other places where you are given tremendous hope.
Better than what you are having
here. Here. So that is not the answer.
That is the answer.
No. Hey,
that
don't
the
write
answer.
A chair.
That is the answer. You.
No, sorry, no.
That is the answer. Babuji, boliye. The question is not only asked to Brahmachari ji, it is asked to everybody here.
No. Brahmachari's question. That applies to me because we thrashed it out, we got nowhere.
Brahmachari ji.
You maintain that Krishnamurti helped me, that Ramana Maharishi helped me, that my sadhana helped me.
Who is it, Babu sir?
No, all of them. Brahmachari more so. He believes. Because you still feel that that will help you and that it helped me. So you are not going to take my word. So your faith and hope is there and not here.
What you said is that I see the difference between you and me because of that. Yes. There is absolutely nothing that I can do. Because of that man, I project the difference on you.
Yeah.
I think that he helped you because you can help me.
Yeah. Yeah.
But why don't you go back there? When I say that it has not helped me.
No, you see, there is a very interesting question he's asking.
You should go back.
The question is, if you feel that he helped him, why don't you go back there?
Yes.
He will help you.
He's not living.
No, if not, I'm not referring to any particular individual.
Anybody?
Yes, Ramana Maharshi is dead.
Other than
yes.
The one,
there are others. That is where you should be.
You should be where people say that there is, I can help you to get that.
Yes, that's where you should be. But you say that because of that I am seeing the difference. But
no, Chandrasekharji, it's a very simple thing. I cannot give you cigarettes. You are knocking at my door. There's a man saying I can give you. Knock at his door.
It's all different belief, no? If somebody says, we don't just go because somebody says. Many thousands
of
people
will say. That's it. Why I am asking you? This is not a rhetorical question. I mean it. You should be there. He is not only selling you the cigarettes, he says his cigarettes are the best in the world. All the other cigarettes are phony. I am not saying that. No, I am not saying that I have the best cigarettes in the world. I am not in that business of selling cigarettes. That's what you are interested in. Good. Why you can't do it?
That means we are not really.
Why you don't do it?
Means we are not really looking for this thing. Otherwise, if we really think of so-called enlightenment, then we look for who will be. But here it's only an attraction. Some attraction.
You say that, but we don't have that feeling that we cannot do.
Yeah.
See, still there is a hope.
The answer is very simple.
What?
Man who is saying he is selling the cigarette, you are convinced that you don't get the genuine product and genuine stuff there, and it might harm you even if you take it. Here is a man who doesn't sell it, and he has got something, he can share that cigarette with you, and that is a good quality you assume, and therefore you not.
There are jokes.
Jokes and jokes. What, Jagadish?
He is selling that he is not selling.
Because he is not a salesman, you find that is the genuineness. And because he is a salesman, is propagandic, he is not getting genuine product to you. You are concerned to share.
No.
That's not to purchase.
You still think that is a genuine product.
Huh?
Still think that
that's
the
genuine. No. Otherwise you would not have come to this door at all.
No.
If you had felt it is a genuine, you would have tapped at that door. No, sir. There I don't agree. It's a question of argument. Sorry.
You're very comfortable.
Yeah.
Got
it, Mahesh?
Adriji?
Yes, sir.
Can you throw some light on our problem?
Yes, sir. We need your help. More support
of all persons.
Yes. Sir. You are an avaduta. You can help us. That's why we just made you come here to pull it out from this.
We just made you come here. Oh, man.
Somebody who is near the Aditya Lodge. What's his name? The who lives in nearer to Aditya Lodge?
Satyanarayana.
That he who comes sometimes, you know, who has six daughters.
Sanjeev Rao.
One day when I was at Sanjeev Rao's house, and I told that he always chased me and why I am hanging around, then the wife told me, you want enlightenment? I said yes. Then she said, okay, you come with me, I will show you another place where he says that he will give enlightenment. Come there. Then I said, no, I am not going. So that's the time I realized I really don't want enlightenment. Because if it is only main thing is enlightenment, then we will go and knock at all the doors who promise us. He really doesn't want to be there. He is promising, come with me. But I didn't want to take it at all. That's the time I realized that actually I don't want it.
Maybe it is too expensive for you.
Which is expensive?
The other one. Whoever is promising.
Huh?
Whoever is promising.
It's expensive for me. Time consuming. I don't want to even try. I don't want to even attempt. I don't want to read any book only because
I don't think that virtually enlightenment is the goal that I'm seeking.
Yeah, that's
I think
what I can
you are a well-read, intelligent man, stimulating company. When you're here, it's good. You throw at times throw light on my area of my work. You say things which are very refreshing.
Recreative, refreshing.
No, very refreshing. You are an interesting, very fascinating person, perhaps I would say the most fascinating person I've met. I think this obsessive thing, to reduce it to an obsessive need of what is hanging around you for enlightenment, is also absurd.
Yes, if it is left at that,
Fine.
Yes,
it was very clear for me on that.
That quality or that whatever you are attributing it to me is gotten from somebody. Gotten from somebody.
It's not at that level, Mahesh. Relate again to our actions.
You see, say, whether you like it or not,
yes,
there is a need in me to look up at somebody.
Yeah.
And he fulfills that need. You see, there is a very beautiful word Salman Rushdie uses. He says, I once believed in God. I no longer believed in God, but I am conscious of the space where God was. So there is a need. You may not believe in the traditional concept of the church, a temple or Rajneesh or whatever. There is a need to look up for somebody, look up to something. But not necessarily in translated in terms of, I don't even know what enlightenment we are talking about. I don't even know anymore.
We are not talking about enlightenment. We were talking about transformation.
Transformation. I'm not
changing.
Even know.
Changing something there.
Who?
Purana.
Purana? From Bombay?
Yes.
How did it grow? How was it today? How many pieces you did? Huh? Where are you?
In Bangalore.
Are you calling me from the direct?